Hi friends, today we will have a quick review on non-invasive ventilation. It means the administration of ventilatory support without using an invasive artificial airway such as ETT and tracheostomy. The use of non-invasive ventilation markedly increased nowadays in both home settings and acute care settings. It has become an integral tool of management in both acute and chronic respiratory failure, and it is widely accepted. We will see the effects of non-invasive ventilation now. It improves the alveolar ventilation to reverse the respiratory acidosis and hypercapnia. It recruits the alveoli and increases functional residual capacity to reverse hypoxia and decrease work of breathing. Next, we will see the advantages of non-invasive ventilation. The best advantage is non-invasiveness. Because of that, it is very easy to implement and remove. It improves the patient comfort and the reduced need of sedation, and it improves the oral patency. Because of that, it preserves the swallowing, speech and cough. Other advantages like avoid resistive work of ETT, avoid complications from ETT injuries, and reduce the cost and length of stay. There are some drawbacks too. First one is slower correction of gas exchange abnormalities and air leak from the mask, and maybe pressure ulcer and eye irritation from the mask. Next, you will see the modalities of non-invasive ventilation. First one is CPAP, continuous positive airway pressure, and second one is BiPAP, is bi-level positive airway pressure. And there is one more optional mode, that is PAV, is proportional assist ventilation. The ventilator will generate pressure in proportion to the patient effort. Next, you will see more about CPAP. CPAP will give continuous positive airway pressure throughout the cycle and decreases work of breathing by alveolar recruitment, and it unloads the inspiratory muscles, and it decreases hypoxia by giving alveolar ventilation, and reduces the intrapulmonary shunt. And the indication for CPAP is acute pulmonary edema and pneumonia. Next, we will see the respiratory effect of BiPAP. It's a bi-level positive airway pressure. It's a combination of EPAP and IPAP. EPAP means expiratory positive airway pressure. IPAP means inspiratory positive airway pressure. This EPAP provides PEEP positive end expiratory pressure, and it improves the FRC, functional respiratory capacity, and it decreases FiO2 required for improving saturation. And IPAP, inspiratory positive airway pressure, it decreases work of breathing and increases the spontaneous tidal volume, thus improve the CO2 clearance and decreases spontaneous respiratory rate. The difference between inspiration and expiration, expiratory pressure will improve the better patient ventilation synchrony, thus improve the patient comfort. The indication for BiPAP, it is acute respiratory failure and COPD. Then the contraindications of non-invasive ventilation. First of all, respiratory arrest. In case of respiratory arrest, the non-invasive ventilation is not suitable. Second, there were poor consciousness or agitation or inability to maintain airway or excessive secretion or vomiting, cardiac arrhythmia and hemodynamic instability, untreated pneumothorax, bowel obstruction, facial trauma and upper airway obstruction. Now we'll look to the complications of non-invasive ventilation. First one is hypoxia, barotrauma, reduced cardiac output, nausea, vomiting and aspiration, gastric distension and pressure ulcer from the mask. Now we have to monitor and document some response to evaluate the effectiveness of therapy. Physiological data are continuous oximetry and exhale tidal volume, ABG, initial and 2 to 6 hours after. Objective data are respiratory rate, chest wall movement, patient ventilator synchrony, and accessory muscle use, heart rate, blood pressure, and mental state. Subjective data, discomfort and dyspnea. Let's wind up. Both CPAP and BiPAP appeared effective in improving respiratory distress even in hypercapnic patients. Choosing the mode of ventilation is the key point of management for better outcome. I hope you enjoy the class. Thanks for watching me. Bye-bye.